writer of science fiction, fantasy, and horror. For many years, I wrote only comics. Then I began to write novels, and now I also write screenplays. Celle qui a tous les dons is certainly my most successful, my most popular novel to date. It's a post-apocalyptic story of a little girl, a young girl, 10-year-old, who is very intelligent, very affectionate, very curious, like any other child, except that she is also a monster. She is a zombie. She's never realized this because her feeding reflex has never been awakened. So she thinks she is a normal child. And it's the story of her adventures, her coming of age in this post-apocalyptic world, her realizing what she is and what her place in the world is, and the decision that she makes as a result of that. She adores her teacher. She has this desperate crush on her teacher, Mademoiselle Justineau, because she has been brought up on an army base where she is effectively a test subject, an experimental lab rat, laboratory rat. Nobody has ever shown her any fondness, any affection. Nobody has ever treated her like a human being, except for this one woman, Mademoiselle Justineau. And so she has a very childlike affection for Miss Justineau. She thinks Miss Justineau is perfect. In the course of the story, she realizes that perhaps Miss Justineau is not perfect, but still, it's kind of a love story about the parental love, the maternal love that the woman has for the child. And once they're out in the world, once they're away from the base, the power relationship shifts. At first, it is Miss Justineau protecting Melanie, but later, Melanie has to be strong enough to protect Miss Justineau. I think as a child, I used to read science fiction because it helped me to escape. I lived in a very poor area, a kind of a ghetto, a slum. We were very, very poor, my family. And science fiction allowed me to dream of different worlds, of other places. But as a writer, I love science fiction and fantasy because there is no subject that they cannot deal with. It's such a wide, open genre with so many different subgenres. You can explore the real world much better under those guises, I think, in science fiction. It's actually not future. It's happening now. It's being filmed now in the Midlands of Britain, around Birmingham, which is a very poor, run-down sort of area, but with great natural beauty. So it gives us a perfect mix of beautiful outdoor exterior landscapes and rather ruined cityscapes. It has Glenn Close as Caroline Caldwell, the scientist. It has Gemma Arterton as Mademoiselle Justineau, and Paddy Considine, an actor I hugely admire, as Sergeant Parks. Melanie is a newcomer. It's her first ever feature film. Her name is Senia Nanua. She's 12 years old and she's brilliant. She is such a great actor already at that young age. And she's working with these Hollywood A-listers, these huge stars, and she just takes it all in her stride. She's very calm and relaxed about it. I wrote the screenplay as well as the novel. There will be another book in this world, I think, another book which deals with that situation, but it won't have the same characters in, because the way the book ends, it changes everything. It would be hard to do a sequel because it would be a very different genre of book, I think. But I would love to write that there is a scene where they find the abandoned tank, Rosie, the Rosalind Franklin, and the crew has disappeared, so come La Marie Celeste. We never find out what happened to those people. So that is a story that I would like to write. But one book that I love and have read and reread again and again and again is The Scar by China Mieville, by the British fantasy writer. It's set on a city at sea, a city that is made by tying together hundreds and hundreds of ships. It's called Armada, the city of Armada. It's an amazing fantasy. He opens up a huge world in a few pages. He has such a powerful imagination. To give the sort of the obvious answer, that there is nothing I want to be more than what I am, a writer. I love writing. But if I could mutate in the way that the X-Men do, if I could have a superpower, I would love to be able to teleport like Nightcrawler, to sort of instantly go from here to London, to New York, to Berlin, to Rome. That would be great, because I hate being on trains and planes.